Yeah, debut at home against Hull, obviously, for obvious reasons. Premier League debut, Swansea debut. Yeah, a brilliant moment for myself and my family as well. They were all up watching it. So for, I think it was 3-1 on the day. So a massive milestone, if you like, for myself and my family as well. I just remember running onto the pitch and saying to Gilfy, there's a change of shape. So that was surreal in itself, going from League Two to playing in the Premier League and coming onto the likes of Gilfy, Baffy Gomes and players like that. And then I remember Baffy scored the third, and I remember sprinting up the pitch to try and be there for, like, if he hit the post or wanted to square it to me, or the keeper saved it or something. But that was probably my biggest memory of that game. But then I think he dinked the keeper and scored, and then I had to wait for him to do his celebration before congratulating him.
Chance for Key to slot in, but here's Jack Cork, another midfielder who's got round one tackle, and he's put through Oliveira in the box. Can he return the favour? In towards Cork! Oh, that's a fabulous goal! What a goal for Swansea City! It was made by Jack Cork. He started the move and then finished it.
I picked that game because, again, going from League Two to coming on in front of 60,000 odd people. And when we won that game, it was, I think, marked the Swans' highest ever Premier League finish. I think it was over 50 points after we won that game. So that was a big milestone for the club. So to be a part of that was special.
You were up there for one of the goals as well, if I remember.
Yeah, I remember celebrating with Corky, actually. I came on left wing, I'm sure, and Nelson Oliveira squared it to Corky, and if he'd have missed it, I mean, I don't think he could have missed it, but if he missed it, I was there again to try and get a little tap in. But I remember him peeling away and celebrating with him, so no, it was a good day.
Well, it's the Championship, it's not the Premiership.
Yeah, Courtney Baker Richardson will do well to avoid a card there, I think, and it's starting to spill over already. And the card is out, it's red, Wyndham.
God, I can't believe that.
Courtney Baker Richardson got sent off within 3 minutes. We like to remind him of it every so often, just so he knows that we're thinking about him. But no, he was sent off. Obviously, the Den's a very tough place to go anyway. So to be down to 10 men that early on was tough, and it was kind of backs against the wall moment. And then you play, and then Leroy gets injured. So he has to go off. So we're thinking, wow, like how many more things can go wrong? And then I just remember Jeff Montero coming on. And for some reason, I took a quick free kick and just passed him the ball. I don't know why I did it, to be honest. Like, in the circumstances, I think it was 1-1 at the time. Like, a point would have been unbelievable. But I just give Jeff the ball and just let him work his magic. He played a beautiful 1-2 with Burst, and then obviously slid in Ollie for the winner. So to go away to the Den and get anything is hard enough. But to win it with 10 men in the last minute, it was madness, absolute madness. And the scenes, I had some friends in the crowd as well that said it was a crazy game and probably one of their favourite away days. So I think it has to go on my list. That was probably a big step forward in the togetherness of the group and the connection with the fans as well.
This is James again. He's got a one-on-one with Otamendi. Moves in field. Dyer. Salina! It's 2-0! Oh, it's a brilliant goal by Swansea City. They ripped apart the Manchester City defence.
Game against Man City. I know we lost the game in the end, but the way we played that day was brilliant, I thought. And yeah, it was just an enjoyable game, to be honest, because obviously, you know how good Man City are. So it was a good way to test yourself against the best team in the country and potentially the world they were at the time. So to play as well as we did, obviously go 2-0 up, and then to lose the game to a penalty that never should have been and an offside goal was heartbreaking. But yeah, no, I was extremely proud of the lads that day, and it was a fantastic match of football that we showed everyone what we were capable of.
20 minutes gone, goalless, but Swansea City have a penalty. Matty Grimes takes 4 or 5 steps, hits it left footed, and the Swans have the lead in the FA Cup quarter final. Matty Grimes scores his first goal in Swansea colours from the penalty spot.
Billy Reid, the assistant gaffer, came up to me before the game and said, like, do you want to take penalties today? And do you know what? Honestly, a part of me was just like, yeah, no problem, thinking we're probably not going to get one. And then when Connor burst through, it was a lovely pass from Mike, and Connor burst through, won the penalty. I thought, yes, get in a pen. And I thought, oh my God, I'm on pens. So it was like, but I was playing at the time with such confidence. I actually never felt like I was going to miss. I've said this in previous interviews before, that I've felt more nervous taking penalties for Northampton against Southend and Wimbledon than I did taking it against Man City. I did not feel a single nerve at all.
Thank you very much. I think it's fair to say that Wyndham and I are looking forward to this one. Swansea don't have the best record at Elland Road. They've had 20 attempts in away games against their hosts today to try and win, and they've won just one occasion, September 1949. So history's not with them.
Obviously, they're a massive club with a massive fan base and a very good team as well. But then we went there, played our stuff, and we stood up to them. We made a few decent blocks. I think Freddie made a few good saves. We defended well, and then Wayne pops up with a winner in the last minute, and I don't think you can beat a last minute winner.
Still the danger not gone. Grimes curls
it in. Yes!
Routledge.
Yes! Yes!
Yes! In!
Get in there!
I was thinking, like, do we take a 0-0 here? And I think, like, probably away to Elland Road, you probably do. Yeah. Away to Leeds, Elland Road, you probably do. But then I remember swinging in the corner, they headed it out and they were just about to break. And I was thinking, oh my God, I'm going to have to sprint in here to make sure, like, nothing happens, because obviously they're dangerous on the counter-attack. And then I just see big Joey Roden's long leg swing round someone and take the ball from them. And it just lands at my feet on my right foot. And I was just thinking, I've not really got the energy to try and dribble past anyone here. I'm just going to kick it in as hard as I can and see if it gets a deflection or falls to someone or something. I think one of their defenders tried to clear it. I think George has a shot or like scuffs something, and it just drops to Wayne in the middle of the box. And as he's hit it, I'm just stood there, and it felt like it went in so, so slowly, because I can't really see through the bodies, because he went like far corner. Can't really see through the bodies where it's gone. And I just remember the net rippling and their players like kind of dejected on the floor, and Wayne peels away. And I actually remember celebrating so much, or like screaming, that I got cramp in both my biceps. It was a hot day. So I think I was lacking a bit of hydration at the end, and I was celebrating and screaming, and yeah, it was a whirlwind, to be honest, even thinking back now. But it was a brilliant day, and someone, I don't know who, made a video on Twitter of the goal to the Titanic music, and I've watched it so many times. I don't know who made it, but I watched it so many times, and it was a it was a brilliant day.
There it is! Swansea City win the Welsh Derby! They dominated against the Cardiff City side. Only 1-0 in the final scoreline, but it could have been a whole lot more.
Yeah, well, I don't think I can play 100 games for this club and not put that one in there. That was a special, special day. Obviously, we know how much the South Wales Derby means to the fans and the community. So we went absolutely all out to make them proud. And obviously, on the day, we did.
Routledge floats it in! Oh, yes! It's the new boy, Wilmot. One game, one goal, and his name already written in Swansea history.
Again, it was like slow motion. It was from a corner, and Wayne crosses it in, and like as Wilmot comes across and heads it, as he heads it into the ground, it just felt like it took forever to go in the back of the net. But then as soon as it did, oh, yeah, the scenes and the atmosphere, you could just feel it. It gives me goosebumps now just talking about it. But no, it was a fantastic day for the club and probably my favourite Swans game.